One summer day in 1970 changed my life. I was 10 years old and living a middle-class existence in Levy, Arkansas, with the simplicity and fun of an Andy Griffith episode, the episodes before color. My three best friends and I enjoyed every day of summer like it was the last day on earth. I hit the ground running by 8 o'clock and would not come back inside until my parents made me at 9 o'clock that night. Back then, summer days were 28 hours long, and we were out of school for 6 months. At least that's how it felt. We'd spend every minute of our day playing, planning, and living like vagabonds. During that summer, we had free rein to ride our bikes wherever we wanted, as long as we told our parents where we were going. That world seems more like a fantasy now. Back then, the worst thing that ever happened to kids was scraped knees or a few stitches. We would bike to the park, to the trails, and to the store to get comic books and banana-flavored bark soda. We never wore helmets or protection of any kind, yet somehow we lived to play another day. This particular day, we had been riding our bikes all around and wound up at the Safeway store. We were a bit hungry and really wanting a snack. The four of us didn't have any money and didn't want to ride all the way home to get any. So a plan was hatched, at least in my head anyway. Being the self-appointed leader of the gang, I had to be resourceful. So, for reasons that remain a mystery to me even today, I devised a scheme. A brilliant and devious plan that would prove me to be both fearless and cunning. I decided to steal some penny candy. You may be familiar with the Brock's candy displays from that time. There was a large bin full of assorted delights, such as caramels, chocolates, and those little white candies with colored pieces embedded in them. My personal favorite. There was a scoop, a scale, and some small white bags. You were supposed to weigh your candy, bag it, and then pay for it at the checkout line. The honor system. Were they really so trusting to think that I had any honor or that I could be stopped by mere guilt alone? That candy was about to be absconded by the next great master thief. As I made my way into the store, I cased the joint just like a pro. In my head, I could hear the theme song to Mission Impossible. Dun, 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 dun. Circling the candy bin, I noticed the butcher to the right doing whatever butchers did. The scrawny high school kids stacking shelves wouldn't have noticed me if I was screaming, "Sock it to me, sock it to me," which I sometimes did. And the woman at the checkout stand was sacking some groceries for an elderly man. This was almost too easy. I started to laugh, but then I didn't. It was go time. My friends were watching, holding my bike for the getaway. On the outside, I was Steve McQueen. On the inside, Barney Fife. This was the start of a crime spree that would most likely end with me being gunned down in a hail of bullets or living barefoot in my villa on an island in the blue waters of the Pacific. Yeah, it's safe to say I'd seen a few movies. I had concocted in my head how my whole life would change after my first taste of larceny. I'm not living life like a sucker. I'm going to take what I want. And right now, I want candy. I positioned myself with my back to the outside with full view of the store. Then, quick as a cat, I snatched a couple of pieces of candy. Pow! Straight into my pocket. This was laughable. I grabbed two more before you could even say Dillinger. Not to be greedy or press my luck, I decided to stop there. Now I had to beat a hasty retreat to my buddies. With a final glance around, I hot-footed to the door, secure in my knowledge that this was not the last of my jobs. I was already planning my next heist as I strolled out. Maybe I could start selling the candy on the black market. Or at recess next school year. I might just buy myself one of those new 8-track tape players I've heard so much about. Approaching the door, everything looked like a dream. It was in slow motion. My friends were laughing and smiling, and I felt like I was walking on air. It was groovy. I had just stepped outside the doors when a force snatched me up in the air. Now, I really was walking on air since my feet were no longer touching the ground. My mind was racing and I was confused. Had I been abducted by aliens? What was happening? My arm was in the grasp of my mother. Without blinking, I immediately went into defense mode. They have the money. I was just going to get it. Of course, my friends were already hitting their strides on their bikes before mine had even hit the ground. I needed new friends. Mom's grip on my arm would be the subject of an investigation from Child Protective Services if it were today. But in 1970, it was just called good parenting. Her speed, strength, and quickness were quite impressive. She dragged me into the store. "You will take this candy to the checkout and tell them what you've done," she said through clenched teeth. "What? Couldn't I give them my allowance for a month or pick up trash?" Mom placed me roughly in front of the checkout woman and said, "Tell her what you did." Obviously, all the adults in my world worked from the same playbook back then. The checker immediately adopted an angry scowl and waited on me to speak. Hot tears streamed down my face from shame and fear as I weakly squeaked out my confession. "I stole some candy from the bin," Mom said. "And?" Well, I was a little confused. The sudden end of my criminal enterprises had left me disoriented. What did she want? The names of my co-conspirators? Had I used a weapon? Did I wet my pants? "Go on, you know what to say," Mom said, and then it hit me. "I'm sorry." I dug into my pocket and fished out the pieces of candy. They wouldn't have tasted any good now because my mouth was full of cotton. The checker was as cold as a February morning as she took back the candy. My mom dragged me outside and told me to get on my bike and go straight home. I was to wait in my room until she got there, when the real punishment would be meted out. My shame was overwhelming. No TV or records for a week. I couldn't leave the yard or play with my friends. It took a year before I could enter Safeway without feeling like every pair of eyes was on me. "There he is, the thief of Levy," they would laugh. The gods had been against me that day, my friends. How else can you explain that the exact moment I begin my first and only act of shoplifting, my mother had just pulled up to the grocery store? Looking through the front windows of Safeway as she walked in, she noticed her youngest son standing by the candy bin. She watched me as I grabbed the candy and made for the doors. Springing into action, she ended my life of crime before it even got started. Pine Sol. She had to buy Pine Sol.